God, I don't want to die. It was scary, because I was dying. I was dying quick. It's devastating. It's the toughest thing to go through. I couldn't think of anything else to do as to just to pray. I said, man, there is a God, and I know there's a God.
Before he was Dr. Death, he was Steve Williams, an All-American wrestler and football player at Oklahoma University.
What most athletes dream of doing, I have done. I went to the Orange Bowl 3 times, the Fiesta Bowl, the Sun Bowl, 2-time Big Eight champion in football, 2-time Big Eight champion in wrestling.
After a short stint in pro football, Steve enters the world of professional wrestling and very quickly becomes a superstar.
And as Dr. Death, I conquered the ring. People were afraid of me because what I could do. I went to the Tokyo Dome. It's 60,000 people, sellout. And I chased the dollar. I really chased it, and I made some big money. I made money that people never see.
Hey, Rubber J, do you know who's in your backyard? The Universal Heavyweight Champion, Dr. Death. Buddy, let me tell you something. With you and the Hulkster fighting for this championship belt tomorrow night at the MGM, trying to take it off my waist, buddy, I'm gonna put you in a headlock and pop your head like a zit.
And you're off talk, Williams. You always want talk, Williams. Dr. Death, the only way you're gonna kill anybody is when you breathe on him. You hear that? You hear that, Dr. Death? What do you think of that?
I'll tell you flat out, I dabbled in it too. I was the outlaw, and I thought drugs could get me away from a divorce and a lot of other things.
On top of the world, in September of 2003, a phone call from his daughter changes everything.
My daughter called me and said, Dad, yes, Tommy, you have cancer. Zoom. For an hour, my daughter and me cried. I thought I was dying. You know, in a lot of hotels, they have a Bible. Well, even in Japan, they got a Bible, and it's an English Bible. Can you imagine that? And I sat there, and I went, what am I going to do? I opened the Bible, and I started reading it. And I really didn't know what to do, y'all. I really was scared to death. And I'm a big old man, and I've never been scared of nothing, nothing. Well, this man was scared to death.
Steve had reason to fear. A stage 4 tumor the size of a golf ball is growing in his throat.
Well, they went in and they cut my head off. Literally cut my head off. They took my vocal cords, my thyroid, cut a nerve to my deltoid. For 3 months, I didn't have a voice, and that was tough.
But at least he was alive and reading the book.
I reached more and more for God. The Bible became my everyday life. I told God, I said, let me live. I have a son, I have a daughter, I have grandkids. I want to live for that. I asked him, I said, I'll finish reading your book. I'm not a book reader, by no means. I'm an athlete, and I went after it. And I told him, I said, I'll finish the book. Every morning at 5 o'clock, I'm up reading the book to start my day.
After 3 grueling months of treatment at MD Anderson, Steve comes home.
Boy, and I laid down and I went to bed, and 4 o'clock in the morning, I woke up. Bleeding to death. I sprung a leak in my stoma, the hole that I'm talking you through, and it was as big as my thumb, and blood was coming out everywhere. I was literally dying in my sleep. Well, God woke me up. And then it's 4 o'clock in the morning. You think anybody's up? Nobody's up. And I can't talk. What do? And all I'm doing is talking to God. No, not like I'm talking to you, but in my mind, I'm talking to God. I'm praying to God. I said, God, I don't want to die. I don't want to die here. I got a little boy who really needs a dad. I got in my truck and I drove 4 hours, 100 miles an hour, down to MD Anderson, Houston. Should have died in my truck. But you know what? You can do anything through Christ, and I'm a true believer. I'm a miracle for it. They looked, all the doctors looked at me and they said, how'd you do this? And I pointed up to God and I wrote it down, God. But it's the only reason I made it. They thought, they couldn't figure out how I made it down there. They said I should have died. Well, there is a God, man. There is a God. I'm a living proof that there's a God. All of a sudden they have a pastor that walks by and they all ask you, you want to pray? And I wrote down, let's all of us say the Lord's Prayer. And so we sat there and we said the Lord's Prayer. And the last thing I remember is when they shot the jungle juice in me, knocked me out for 10 hours. I was holding on and embracing with my brother. And we were both crying. Because we didn't know if I was gonna come back. Well, again, I'm gonna put the glory to God. He wasn't done with me. He wanted me to come back and speak the word.
Against all the odds, today Steve is cancer-free. He spends his time now coaching his son's middle school football team, training young wrestlers, and telling anyone every chance he gets how Dr. Death became Dr. Life.
Well, Dr. Life became alive. Dr. Death died. Went right out of my body. The evil guy that conquered the world on his own and did all the wild and crazy things was gone. Now this guy who was reborn, Dr. Life. What a life story. About God is what I want people to understand. Sure, there's a life in this book about a great athlete, but I want people to understand there is a real God. He's in the healing business. And he can take you places that you'll never imagine. It's so easy to get him into your life. All you have to do is ask him to forgive your sins and ask him into your life. It's so simple. And you know what? Your life will start changing. God is the answer to everything. You know, drugs, alcohol, women, men, fast cars. I've had it all. Let me tell you something. The best thing I've ever had was God. I mean, he's taken me to places that I never imagined. Steve Williams preaching, well, I got one thing to tell people. See these hands? I've got all these gold rings, and I mean Big A champions, Orange Bowls. These hands are big hands, and I've done beat up the biggest and the baddest men in pro wrestling. And you know what I get to do now? Matter of fact, I've done a lot of drugs with these hands too. And you know what I get to do now? I get to put them together and I get to pray. I get to talk to God. I get to tell him how great he is and how much I love him.